Hi everyone, my name is Talia and I will be talking about a manga today. So I've never really reviewed a manga before, I just kind of compared it to anime before, so that's kind of it. So it's my first manga review and this will be about Bakuman and it's volume 1. So starting at the beginning, and I'm gonna try to review a volume every week or so. I have up until volume 4 now. And I actually bought it at the FAST convention, so this is all new to me. I didn't know what I got into when I bought it. I didn't know what it was about exactly. I didn't know it was about making manga, and it was about two guys, because I've seen pictures of the anime and all that stuff, but I never saw the anime, I never saw a trailer, I never read the synopsis actually. So I was just like, at FAX, I was like, I'm just gonna buy this and I will see where this will take me, because it's with the creators from Death Note. So I was like, how can this be really bad? I don't think it will be, otherwise they wouldn't have had like 20 volumes or something, I think it is, in a anime. So yeah, I was just curious, and that is how I got Bakuman. Bakuman is basically about two guys who want to make a manga, a successful manga, and one does just the writing and the other one does the art. And there's one main character, and his name is Moritaka, and he's just like not shy, but he's not over social either. And he's doing good at school and all that stuff, but he doesn't really have a goal in life. Then he meets the other guy, and his name is Akito. He is a really funny guy, very social, very happy all the time as well. When you have like Moritaka, who is more like not down, but he's just not really interested too much in anything. He does draw, but that's where it goes. He doesn't do anything else. His uncle was a manga artist though, and his work has been published, and he made an anime from his manga as well. So he was pretty popular, but it was only for a short time, and he kind of looked up to his uncle. But then his uncle passed away due to overworking, but Moritaka thought it was suicide because he couldn't get there, like he couldn't be very successful, so he thought it was because of that. And that's just kind of how the story starts. Like, it's just the two main characters, Moritaka and Akito, learning to know each other on a very funny way, I think. I really enjoyed how they met each other. It was just very random because Moritaka just left his notebook at school and we got a Death Note reference right away. So I was like, okay. I was expecting references, but not like right away. So I thought that was pretty funny, and I really did enjoy that. And I really like how the character of Akito is, because he's just funny in the way he reacts, and just his expressions on his face are funny as well. And then how Moritaka reacts to him is very dry and sarcastic, and that is what I like as well. So those two characters are very different from each other, and I like that. I like how they are bonding and all that stuff, although they are very different and have different pasts and all that stuff. Because also, Akito is very smart, so he doesn't have any problems in school and stuff, but Moritaka does have to study for his grades. So yeah, the whole story starts out pretty funny, I think. Well, not funny, but like the death of his uncle, because like the first on the first chapter we just get like a flashback right away of like Moritaka and his uncle just like talking and hanging out and all that stuff. And you could really see, like, you could feel the connection between Moritaka and his uncle. Like, they got along very well, so that means a lot to me, like when they keep using that thing in the manga, because you kind of have to know like what their connection was. So, and you kind of see more of the family as well, but it's only like his grandpa, I believe, and his mother. And his mother, I'm not too sure about, because she's all right, but she's just a typical mother who is very worried, which is normal, I guess. And when they actually team up, like Moritaka and Akito, they just want to go for it then, because at first Akito is like, eh, I don't know, and then they team up, and I like how that progresses, like how Moritaka really kind of changes because of Akito, and how he can like influence him a lot because of just them being different but just connecting as well. And then you have the big thing that changes everything, which is Azuki, the girl from his class. So he's in love with her, but she's I don't know, she doesn't talk too much and he doesn't either, so that's like kind of a communication problem between those two. So that's kind of weird though about the manga, because he goes to her house to like confess because of Akito. He dragged him there and he says, do you want to marry me? So that was a funny fucked up scene, I'll say. And because she says yes, so I was like, okay, so this is happening apparently. So if they both reach their goals, she will be a voice actress and he will be a manga artist. If they get anything published and all that stuff, they will be together. But how is that going to work if they haven't said a word yet to each other? They have been not flirting, but they have been like looking at each other since like way back apparently. So they kind of had a crush for each other already, but they didn't knew it about each other. And Akito knew it right away when they saw how they were acting. Yeah, it's weird. Like in some way I was like, how is this possible? Like, this isn't realistic at all. But then I was like, it is a manga, it is not real life, and this is just how the story is. So I was like, okay, I'm fine with it then. And yeah, I guess that just happened. It went very fast how those two were like, okay, I will marry you. So yeah, that happened in the second chapter, I'm not sure, but yeah, it happened very soon. So yeah, I'll just see how that goes between the two. But for the first volume, there has been a little bit development between the two, but they haven't really spoken to each other yet, except for like that night at her house, and he has spoken to her mother. And yeah, they have seen each other at the street, staring at each other when they were like passing by, and they felt a connection. So I don't know, I'm just really hoping that they will talk more and all that stuff, or at least get her email address, because he doesn't have her email address yet in the first volume, and like days have passed and he doesn't have her email address yet, so they can't like contact each other, which is kind of weird as well. So I just hope he will get her contact information soon, so we will see more development in like the romance stuff. Speaking of romance, we kind of like at the end of this volume, we kind of have like romance development, not for the main character, well, not for Moritaka, but for Akito, which was interesting. I didn't really see that coming, because he doesn't really look like the romantic type, while Moritaka is a really romantic guy and he just wants like romantic scenes and all that stuff. But then again, you have to think about their age, they're only still 14, but still, if the like how the manga goes on, they will be older. So I'm hoping that he will change a bit in that, like that he will be more realistic, and we'll just have to wait for that. But Akito, he actually likes a girl from school as well, turns out. Well, the girl likes him more, that is for sure right now, because she actually has a crush on him, because she told Akito a secret about Azuki, which is like the whole voice acting thing. No one was supposed to know that, and Akito knows that about her because of her friend, and he's in love with that friend. So, well, in love, I don't know, they're just, I think it's just a crush for both of them, but I'm kind of hoping there will be romance development for those. And maybe because of Akito and that girl, Miyamori, I think is her name, Miyoshi is her name, maybe because of that, the other couple will develop as well. I'm hoping that. But yeah, enough about the whole romance thing, because that isn't the main subject of the whole manga. We have just the two boys working on manga, learning how to draw a storyboard, because Akito didn't know anything about that. He was like, I can write, but I never like did like how does the storyboard work and all that stuff. He didn't even know it existed, so that was pretty new to him. And I would like, most people probably would have thought that he would know what that is, since he is such a smart kid, but he didn't. So I was actually glad that he could learn from Moritaka. So that was like, okay, they can just teach each other stuff about that, because Moritaka basically knows almost everything about manga because of his uncle. And so he has kind of like experience in that, just like seeing stuff. And they got that studio from his uncle, which was like a big part in the whole first volume. And I really liked the studio. I was so jealous when I saw that, like all the Shonen Jump manga and like the weekly Shonen Jump stuff and the pencils and like the whole, all the folder cases that they had from his uncle and references and all that stuff, just so they could learn and actually make a manga themselves. And they just had a place for two guys just making up manga stories and draw there the whole time. So I really liked that. I was just jealous seeing that. Did you see how much manga there was in there? I was like, oh god, if I will see this animated in the anime, I will be like, not this scene again, I want to live there. That looked just so awesome. But yeah, anyways, the whole thing with them making manga was pretty interesting. Like, what kind of pen do you use, the storyboard, how do you actually draw it, and how much time does it take? Because it takes so much time, and you could see how Moritaka was so tired, but he said it was worth it. So that made me happy that he was like, this is the first time that I feel happy about like working for stuff and all that, and it doesn't feel like it's wasted time. So I'm glad that that whole scene was in there, and also how Akito wanted to help him because he's only just like writing the storyboards and that's going pretty fast for him. In the meantime, he's just reading other manga and that's kind of it. So he just has to wait till Moritaka is done with like all the drawings, which takes so much more time. And he felt guilty and he wanted to help, so that was pretty sweet as well. And he actually did his homework the whole time because just to save time so he could just draw more and be more focused on it and all that stuff. So yeah, that was pretty awesome to see. I really like those scenes when they were just together making stuff and connecting to each other, talking about manga. Like, a lot of references from other manga were in there and I enjoyed that. I was like, oh, that's cool, and he likes sports and he likes this and he likes this. Like, it was interesting because sometimes based of what kind of anime and manga people like, you can already kind of guess what kind of person that is. I don't know if that's only me, but sometimes I feel like I can just base that off that kind of stuff, or like video games and all that stuff. Like, I can just kind of guess what kind of person that is. Not exactly, of course, but you know what I mean. So yeah, I just like the whole connecting thing between those two, and I really enjoyed that. And then we had the end of the volume, which was pretty exciting because they finished the manga, The Two Earths. So that was like the story that Akito made up. He made up a lot of other stories already because he has more time because he is a writer. And yeah, it's good that he is making more stories already because they should have like a backup if they want to do something else or whatever, because we have that other guy, that 15-year-old that got published because he was a finalist from a contest or something. So they were pretty jealous about that, and I like how they were like, oh no, this guy can do this, okay, because of that we can do it too. Like, it motivated those two, and especially Moritaka, it really motivated him to just work harder, and that is why he did those too many hours and he slept barely and he fell asleep in class and all that. That was a funny scene as well when he went to the nurse's room just to talk, basically. Yeah, but yeah, anyways, at the end we actually have them going to an editor, which is pretty exciting, and I can't wait what will happen in the next volume because they were pretty nervous about it as well when they were like calling them already, and they actually went through so they can go there, which is I think an exception because they said in that office that they wouldn't take high school students who just want to show them their new manga that they made. So they might have recognized the number because it is at his uncle's apartment, like studio. So they might have recognized that number because of that. And they could have been like, maybe it's like family and we can just give them a shot. So I'm just thinking that is what happened, that they just recognized the number somehow. So yeah, we'll just see what will happen in the second volume. I can't wait to read it because it goes by very fast, like time when you're reading it. There's the dialogue is done pretty good as well, and like I said, the art for me is wonderful. Like, I'm really enjoying it and all the detail that is in it. It's just a fast read for me, actually, and I'm quite surprised by that. So yeah, I'm really enjoying it, and we will see how it will go with the romance and like the whole manga thing. So I do like the combination of those two, and that there is more, it's more focused on the manga stuff than like the romance stuff. The romance is just like a push to those two to work harder, because that's the big goal is still like the manga. So that's a good thing. So yeah, anyways, let me know in the comments what you thought of Bakuman, the first volume. You can compare it to the anime if you want. I haven't seen that one yet. I do plan on watching it, but I want to finish all the volumes of Bakuman first, and then I will watch the anime. So yeah, like I said, leave your thoughts in the comments. And if you like this video, you can give it a thumbs up. And if you haven't subscribed yet and you want to, you can still do that here or on my channel. And that's it. So hope you enjoyed this video, and I will see you soon. Bye.